Good morning, children. This is Aruna Rajaputra with today's topic, Movements of the Earth, Their Effects, Class 5, CBSE Social Studies. Let us see, children. These are the planets which revolve around the Sun. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Among all these planets, Earth is the third planet which revolves around the Sun. Earth is a special planet. It is a special planet than other planets because life is possible here. And it is also, life is possible because the layer of air which is called atmosphere is found only on the Earth. And it is also called a blue planet. It is called a blue planet because 3/4 of the Earth is covered with water and 1/4 is surrounded by, covered by land. Next, so let us learn the movements of this Earth in this topic. So movements of the Earth, their effects. This is the shape of the Earth. The satellite image of the Earth, which shows the shape of the Earth. Shape of the Earth is spherical. And we studied this Earth with the help of a globe. Globe is the model of the Earth. And you see here the Earth is tilted to 66.5 degrees to the plane of the Earth's orbit. So the globe is tilted at a particular angle. Just like the globe, the Earth is also tilted. Here, this picture shows you how the Earth is tilted. A line is drawn through the center of the Earth, joining the North Pole and the South Pole. This line, imaginary line, is called an axis of the Earth. This axis is tilted at 66.5 degrees to the plane of the Earth's orbit. The Earth spins from west to east on this axis. This picture shows the Earth spins from west to east on its axis, and the Earth has the movements, two movements. The movements of the Earth are rotation and revolution. What is rotation, children? The spinning of the Earth on its axis is called rotation. The Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Here, on this axis, Earth is spinning from west to east. This picture shows the Earth rotates on its axis. What is the effect of this rotation? Effect of the rotation. The rotation of the Earth causes day and night. When the Earth rotates, only one part of the Earth will face the Sun. Here, this part is facing the Sun, while the other part remains away from the Sun. The part that faces the sunlight or receives the sunlight has the day, while the other part, which is in the darkness, has the night. This picture shows the rotation of the Earth causes day and night. Sunlight, sun rays falling on the Earth. The part of the Earth receiving the sunlight, day is caused. And the part of the Earth which did not receive the sunlight, night is caused. The activity of the day and night. Do this activity when it is dark or at the night, children. Take a torchlight and a ball. Make the torchlight as a sun and a ball as an earth. On the torchlight, imagine like the sun. The rays of the sun fall on the ball, which you have to imagine like the earth. And the part of the earth which receives the sunlight is day, and the other part which does not receive the sunlight is night. Next, the sun always rises in the east. Can you say the reason, children? Yes. As the earth rotates from west to east, east part of the earth always faces the sun. So it seems that sun always rises in the east. This is the reason why places in the east get exposed to the sunlight first. Hence, the time is ahead of the east. Ahead of the time in the places in the east than to the west. What is revolution? The earth, this picture shows the earth revolves around the sun. The earth rotates and also revolves around the sun in a fixed path, which is called an orbit. The earth completes one revolution in 365 1/4 days, but we have only 365 days on our calendar. The 1/4 day of every year is added to make one extra day. This extra day is added every 4th year to the month of the February. Hence, February has 29 days every 4th year instead of 28 days. A year with 366 days is known as a leap year. What is the effect of revolution? The revolution of the earth on a tilted axis around the sun causes seasons. And the earth travels around the sun at 107-244 kilometers per hour. In the above picture, you can see when one part of the earth faces the sun, the other part is away from the sun, which causes seasons. There are four main seasons: summer season, autumn season, winter season, and snowfall will be more in the hilly areas during this winter season. And this picture shows you the spring season. So the revolution of the earth on a tilted axis around the sun causes seasons. When one part of the earth faces the sun, the other part is away from the sun. The part of the earth that faces the sun experiences summer, while the other part experiences the winter. When northern hemisphere experiences summer in the June, the southern hemisphere experiences winter at that time, and vice versa. This picture shows you the revolution of the earth that causes seasons. This picture, A figure, in June month, it is summer season in northern hemisphere and winter season in the southern hemisphere. In this figure B, it is autumn season in the northern hemisphere and spring season in the southern hemisphere. In this figure C, it is winter season in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. In this picture D, it is spring in the northern hemisphere and it is autumn in the southern hemisphere. So the revolution of the earth causes seasons. It is very clear with this picture. Task for this video: write in your own words how seasons are caused. And the another task is, in which hemisphere is your city you live in, northern or southern hemisphere? In which hemisphere is your city you live in, northern or southern hemisphere? Which season are you experiencing now and why? You have to write. So thank you all, children. Have a nice day.